Hi there, and welcome to another Film Impact video tutorial. Today I'm going to show you another logo reveal, and I'm doing a bunch of series on creating logo reveals right inside Premiere Pro, because using our tools for creating logo reveals is so powerful, and you can have things done so quick, like just a blink of an eye. Well, I mean, it really takes, I think, less than 15 minutes to create a cool logo reveal like this one. So this one is very elegant. It has kind of the bulge on the edges, and it's nicely laying down each separate element of this logo. So I've already prepared this logo in Photoshop. So open up Photoshop and just showing you that this logo is actually a logo on separate elements being spread out here on different tracks. So if you don't know how to convert a logo to a layered Photoshop file, there's a separate tutorial on that from EPS to layered Photoshop file. So already done so, just going back into Premiere, double click to import and say, okay, this is the logo we want to import, just import. And now Premiere is asking what to do with all these separate layers. Do you want to merge it all? No, no, no. You want to import that as a sequence. Just select sequence, hit OK. And now it's it created a bin with all the layers being spread out and a sequence. Just double click the sequence there, and you'll find that it has all the separate layers, so 22 video tracks. And the upper track is the one it's corresponding to the triangle, the blue triangle. And then I've named each layer so we know what each element is. So for example, we've got the B here, we've got the back black background here. I might as well take that down because it's giving that transparent look, and we want that. I mean, you want to overlay this logo animation on top of your video. Now, to start working with animating this logo, you kind of get to look at the logo and see what it gives you. I mean, we've got the triangle here, and you can do a couple of things. And one of the things that I'd like to do is maybe do a flip, sort of a card flip. So in the FX browser, go to the video transition section and open up the Film Impact animation series. And this is so cool for creating these kind of logo animations. Just drag and drop the flip motion impacts and see what it does out of the box. So it has kind of that bouncy look, and something you may or may not like. I'm going to give this a little bit more room to breathe. And again, it's nicely revealing this triangle element here. And in the effects browser, you'll see that it's actually taking this bounce curve. And we have several options here. For example, an overshoot. And that looks very elegant, by the way. And I think we're done already. I mean, you might want to change the angle, but I kind of like it this way, so it's good. Let's go further and see what we can do with the brand name. And like I said, I've got each letter being spread out on different tracks. And what we can do here, maybe have things, have the letters come down from the top, and just below, let's say there's this invisible line here. I'm gonna do the push, and this is actually a push with a crop, and I'm gonna apply it to the A because the A is being nicely here, so I can kind of see where I want to have things cut off. So by default, it just drops the A, right? And again, it does the bounce look. Maybe for this, we just select the Bezier curve and see, I mean, this is slowing down and just drops the letter, right? So slowly doing that. And around here, I want it to appear. And we have built-in crop tools here. So cropping, let's crop from the top and see where we see the visible point. Okay, right here. Now, just give it a little bit more room between the blue element and do some feathering. And you can either do a positive feathering, will go up, or feather it down. So if we would want to do that, let's increase the crop all the way down and now do a feathering. So you know we haven't cropped off anything else besides. So it's visible all the way here. So nothing gets cropped off here, but just before things are cropped. So this is good. Play with that if you want to do some more. That's perfect. So there you go. All right. And at this stage, basically the A is dropping down all the way from the start. And the transition, now that we've set the cropping tools here, it actually shows us it's actually the visible part of the transition is just below 50%. So what we can do is play with the timing control, so transition timing, and have the transition start at say 45%. So and see if that's all the way visible here. Yeah, I mean you could even push it and say 50 and see if that works. So yeah, that works. Beautiful. And now we kind of get to use this entire section of the video transition. So that's good. Perfect. Play with the timing and see if that works. Okay, beautiful. Now I'm going to show all the layers here. And what I'm going to do, so we have the brand name and the tagline. I'm going to just move that aside. And what you can do is select the transition, hit Command C to copy the transition. Now Command Drag to select all the endpoints here and just paste. There you go. So going back, see how that looks. Okay, so that's good, but it's doing it all at once and have that timing dynamics. It kind of lacks the timing dynamics, but that is easily added. So what I'm going to do, just select select the layers, hit plus one on the keyboard, deselect the lower, again do plus one, and just move along until you've created this little stair in this sequence. And this will create just an offset by one frame, and one frame or two frames, even, I mean, you might even do three, but even doing one frame offsets does give that dynamics. Well, it could use two frames here, right? So again, just do plus one, just repeat this process, and this will create that offset, the dynamic timing offset, which really adds a nice, elegant, but yet simple look on revealing the brand name. Now, now for the tagline, you know, this is the subtitle. So I always want to reveal the brand name, the initial, that should go first, right? The tagline should be simpler. I don't know if that's the word, but I would say we don't have to do each letter at once. Just have this entire section merged. So this is the entire tagline. So tagline from the logo text, right? So now it's been merged out. Let's close the gap here. So going back, and now we see, okay, so the tagline. And one of the transition I like for doing text is the stretch wipe impact. So there you go, stretch wipe impacts, and see what it does out of the box. So by now, oh wow. So this is cool, right? So it's doing a nice blur. It's kind of a glowy feel. Let's give it a little bit more room to breathe, and let's change the angle. Make it come from the right. So just change the angle here. All right. So that will be minus 90. So beautiful. And now we kind of get to see. Yeah, this is good. I'm gonna reveal it a little bit sooner now. So that's beautiful here. So I haven't touched any dials. I mean, you could emphasize the movement and give it more power by increasing the stretch or even the exposure. But for what I see, this is enough. And now, by just looking at the entire logo reveal, I can tell in the timing, this one can be... You get to play with the timing of the transition, and if it doesn't play back smoothly, just drop the preview resolution to a quarter. There you go. And this looks good. I mean, this feels elegant. And now we've done the basic logo reveal. And don't stop here, because we can add stuff now, and that will bring up the level of quality. This will increase the professional look. We can kind of play with it as it is right now. So it's doing a very basic logo reveal. So I'm going to select all elements. So Command A, right click, and do nest. And say, so this is the basic logo animation. And this is part one. And now, all the way down, we've got a squeezed sequence. If I double click it, it will bring back the basic logo animation sequence. And right here, it is nested inside this sequence. And again, this is a beautiful logo animation, right? And now we're going to add something, and we're going to look outside of the animation series. Now, I would recommend going into the distortions or the transformer section. Let's see what we've got. We've got, okay, let's do a liquid distortion impacts and see how that works. So I'm going to just drop it on and see what it does. So this is a very... distorted look, might be too much there for a logo reveal, but hey, we can tweak and play with this, right? So select the transition and see if we can dial back the strength of the liquefied impact, right? Just turn down the dolly and turn down the vertigo. To see, now it just does a dissolve, and let's do the dissolve over the entire length of the video transition. And okay, give it more room to breathe. So all we have is a dissolve, right? And now increase the vertigo. See how that works. Say give it 100, and see how that works. So now. Ooh, this is actually very, very nice. I mean, the letters are outside this region. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the sequence settings and give it more room to breathe. Right now, this is 1080 by 1080. Let's do 1920 by 1920. And now it's a square. And we have more room to breathe here. Okay, there you go. I mean, we can even add more vertigo if we want, right? So this is good, and now things are again. It's sitting too close near the edge, so I'm gonna drop it to say 150, and even play with the center of the bulge. I mean, this is kind of an inverted bulge. It's got the vertigo effect. And there you see, I mean, you're really adding another cool element to this logo reveal. And again, I'm going to look for this and see if I think it's right. And at this stage, I'm kind of not seeing the flip anymore. So I can double click this and go to the flip motion and just move with the timing. Just add a couple of frames of delay there and see if that is now visible. Oh yeah. Now I can kind of see the rotation. It's starting here and it's coming very nicely. And there you go. So this is a very, very cool, nice logo reveal. And just to confirm, we've got everything done. Let's give it full res, set an in point, out point, and do a render into out, so we can have everything being rendered out so we can really experience the timing and the look and feel of this video transition and see if any adjustment need to be done. But see how that beautiful and gracefully adds on the logo. And so it's kind of bulging and blending and it's while revealing all the text, and this looks very, very nice. And so this is it. This is the steps I would take to create a logo reveal. If you have created your own logo reveal using the Film Impact animation series, please send us a message and show it. I mean, we'd love to see what you've created. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.